Hello from Vewana International Airport. We are starting a little trip to Southeast Asia. For 12 days, we are going to explore 5 countries. First Singapore, then Myanmar, Laos, Cambodia, and Malaysia. We are already in Singapore. Look how many orchids and how are real. Our first stop in Singapore is Changi International Airport. It is major aviation hub in the Asia Pacific and currently rated the world's best airport. If you need to change terminals in Changi Airport, you keep in mind the distances are quite huge. We are changing now from Terminal 4 to Terminal 1st, and we are getting first a shuttle, free shuttle, and then a sky train. So everything needs time. It's very well organized, very beautiful, but the space needs time. Singapore is island country in Southeast Asia, 15th smallest country in the world. Translated from Sanskrit, the name of this city country means Lion City. From previous British colony, Singapore became one of the world's most prosperous, tax-friendly countries and the world's busiest port. Singapore is modern, densely populated metropolis, but at the same time very green, clean and beautiful. Singapore is the country with best paid government and no corruption. It is the safest country in the world. Crime here is practically non-existent. Very unique feature of Singapore is the ability for many religions and cultures to live in harmony, respecting and celebrating each other. Probably one of the reasons this country to be so successful is people are keeping the rules. Some of the rules are a bit ridiculous, as chewing gum is banned, but the result of keeping the rules is high developed economy and very good standard of life. Other thing Singapore is very famous with is the delicious and diverse food. It is a must to try the chili crabs in Geylang and the delicacies from the Chinatown Street Food and the small restaurants in Little India and Arab Street. Singapore is interesting destination, not exactly budget as the majority of the countries in Southeast Asia, but there are options to enjoy this beautiful country not spending fortune of money. In the video we are giving idea what you can explore for day and a half in Singapore. Marina Bay Sands is an integrated casino, shopping destination, entertainment and hotel. That is probably Singapore's most iconic landmark since opening its doors in 2010. The view from its infinity pool is indescribable. Cooling down in the lobby of Marina Bay Sands. It's very nice here. Magnificent garden by the bay. and just behind it, marina bay sands. Gardens by the Bay is a modernistic park which consists of three waterfront gardens, include giant artificial trees that glow in the nighttime. The Garden Rhapsody light show is free and takes place twice nightly. Gardens are also free. Gardens by the Bay is home to more than 40 sculptures from around the world, featuring unique pieces, intriguing crafts and stoneworks. These sculptures complement the beauty of the plant displays and add a new dimension to the landscape. The cheapest way to go around Singapore is the underground MRT. You can purchase AZ-Link contactless smart card directly from the airport station for 12 Singaporean dollars, inclusive of $5 non-refundable card cost and $7 credit. You can recharge it according to your journeys. You can use the same card for the bus transport too. If you have less time, taxi transport is also not so cost-effective option. The normal tariff for the taxis, the starting one is $3.6, and per kilometer the tariff is 55 cents. Luxury limousine taxis are around 20% more. This is the Merlion, the symbol of Singapore. We're having some delicious food in the Geylang area. We have dosa. This is egg, onion paratha, biryani, prawns, and sausage paratha. And some chicken additional to the biryani. Sentosa is the fourth largest island in Singapore, and it is a famous recreation and tourist attraction place. You can enjoy attractions as Madame Tussauds, Marine Life Park, Butterfly Park and Insect Kingdom, 4D Adventureland. There are also three beach areas where you can enjoy water sports, to relax on the sun, to get a drink from the beach bars. There are also nature trails, parks. You can visit or stay in Resorts World Sentosa, and to experience attractions as Casino, Universal Studios Theme Park, Adventure Cove Water Park and CEA Aquarium. Transport options to reach Sentosa from mainland are public bus, monorail and cable car. Go now and have some Chinese dessert. Almond ice and red sesame. This is a mix almond and red sesame.
பாதமே அம்பலவானனே சிதம்பரத்தில் வாழும் சிவகாமி நேசரே ஆரிய பாதமே அம்பலவானனே சிதம்பரத்தில் வாழும் சிவகாமி நேசரே
Very interesting atmosphere in this temple. They're starting the preparation for one very big Indian celebration now. What was the name?
Deepavali.
Deepavali.
Chinatown is Singapore's traditional Chinese quarters. Very interesting sites there are Buddha Tooth Relic Temple and Sri Mariaman Temple. And for delicious Chinese cuisine, you have to try some of the restaurants in the food street.
We are now in the Geylang area. This is the part of Singapore with the cheapest accommodation, cheapest hotels you can find here. But this is also the red light area of Singapore. So be aware of it.
Geylang is one of Singapore's oldest Malay settlements.
For watching Traveling Channel. Follow us for more interesting traveling stories and tips. See you soon!